friends, what's up? Welcome to my channel Home Cooking. Today we are going to make an instant dhokla, which is very famous savory in Gujarat. You don't have to do any pre-preparations for this, it's made right up. So let's get started.
First we need is a steamer. It is also known as dhokaryu in Gujarat. So I have added water and added plate to it. Now we drizzle oil and we grease it. This will help to not stick to the plate. It is very important to grease and then off the lid, and then we slow the flame. Now for the preparations of dhokla, all we need is 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of citric acid, 3 teaspoons of sugar, a cup of gram flour and a glass of water. In a bowl, I add a glass of water. In goes my sugar. We stir it continuously until it dissolves nicely. As you can see, the sugar is dissolved. Now in goes 1 teaspoon of salt. We stir it continuously until it blends with the mixture. Now in goes 1 teaspoon of citric acid. Once everything is done, we add gram flour and we have to continuously keep on stirring it while adding the gram flour. This will help to aerate the mixture and we don't want any lumps in our dhokla batter. After you can see no lumps, I'll add 1 tablespoon of gram flour more. With the help of a whisker, this will aerate nicely, give us perfect consistency. As you can see, this is the consistency we are looking for. It's semi-thick consistency. Now, here comes the showstopper. In 1 teaspoon of soda, I'll add 3 teaspoons of water. This is very important. This will help to rise our dhokla perfectly.
Add soda into our dhokla batter. As you can see, a slight color change and rising it up, will continuously stir into one direction. Now it's time to pour it into our hot steamer. Be careful while adding into a hot steamer. You can also add this with the bowl. Now we close the lid and let it set for 15 minutes.
Now let's check whether dhokla is ready. We will slow the gas. We will open it. And we will do a knife check. If the knife comes out clear out of it, then the dhokla is ready. It's correct time to decorate it. For tempering, all we need is the seeds, jeera, chilies, I've split it into half, curry leaves, coriander, cilantro, and oil. Into 1 tablespoon of oil, I'll add 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds. Once it's splutter, I'll add jeera to it. In goes my curry leaves, then the chilies. We will stir it nicely. Now it's time to cut the dhokla. Once we cut it into our required pieces, it's time to decorate it. The tempering is very important. This is the perfect recipe that I have learned from my bhabhi. The credit goes to Ami bhabhi and Dara bhabhi. If at all you're watching it, thank you so much for teaching me this. It's really yum, guys. Do try it at your home and let me know into the comments, and do subscribe my channel.
Let's check how our dhokla has come out. Yes, it's a perfect market style. As you can see, it's nice, spongy, soft, with a very handy ingredient, guys. Now you don't have to buy it from the market. A huge demand from few of my friends are now ready to serve this perfect instant dhokla. Do try it at your home and let me know into the comments, but don't forget to subscribe my channel. See you in the next video. Bye.